Hello everyone, welcome to Nepal Digital Education. It's me Rajesh Thapa, your math tutor. In this video, we'll be discussing about course contents of mathematics of science stream of class 12. Mathematics of class 12 of science stream has three groups. All the topics have been divided into three groups. You can see here, group A contains altogether 11 topics, group B contains 4 topics, and group C contains 4 topics. Group A is compulsory. Students have to study all the topics of group A, and group B or C, either group B or group C, students will be selecting. Students have to select one of the groups, either B or C. Group A, the first topic of group A is permutation and combination, which is related to counting principle, the number of ways of selection, the number of ways of arrangement. And from this topic, questions of 2 plus 4 equal to 6 marks will be asked in examination. Second topic, binomial theorem. From this topic, about marking scheme will be studying, will be discussing later on. Third topic is elementary group theory. Their binomial theorem is related to expansion of binomial expression. Like if a plus b whole square, then we know the formula is there, a square plus 2ab plus b square. But in case of a plus b to the power 10, it is difficult to expand it. So about expansion of this and many other things, we'll be discussing under this topic, binomial theorem. Third, elementary group theory, which is related to binomial, which is related to binary operation on sets of integers and their properties. Conic section is related to intersection of plane and cone. Different curves will be formed. About those L curves, parabola, ellipse, circle, will be studying under this topic, conic section. Coordinate in space, the fifth topic, coordinate in space. It is related to 3D, the point in space. Next, vector and its application. Under this, we'll be discussing about dot product, vector product, and vector application in field of geometry. The way, the proof of different formula with the help of vector we'll be discussing in this topic. Derivative, you might have studied this in class 11, you have studied, it is related to rate of change. First principle will be there and different formula to find out derivative and its application. Antiderivative, the integration, the reverse process of derivative, antiderivative, the standard integration will be studying in this topic. Differential equation, the equation which contains derivative and how to solve such equations, this will be studying in this. Dispersion, correlation and regression, it is related to statistics, probability, random experiment and probability to determine probability of getting an event, empirical probability, classical meaning of probability, exclusive events, non-mutually exclusive event, mutually exclusive events, conditional probability, many more things are there which we'll be discussing in this topic. Similarly, group B has four topics: statistics, statics, dynamics, which are related to physics. These all are the topics related to physics. Then group C. Students will be taking either group B or group C, where group A is compulsory. Now group C, linear programming related to optimization, computational method and numerical integration. In this way, students will be altogether studying 15 topics in class 12 mathematics. From each topic in the final examination, question of 2 plus 4 equal to 6 or 2 plus 6 equal to 8 marks will be asked. Now let's discuss about the marking scheme, evaluation scheme. How many questions will be there in the final examination? You can see the table. There will be 15 questions, each of 2 marks, covering all the units. From every unit, there will be a very short question of 2 marks, 11 questions from group A, and 4 questions from B or C, altogether 15 marks. 15 into 2, 30 marks questions, very short question. Similarly, short question of 4 marks, there will be 10 questions with 4 or questions, 4 alternative questions from same topics. There will be 10 questions where 4 questions will be with or, 10 into 4 equal to 40 marks, and 5 questions will be there each of 6 marks with 2 or question, 2 alternative question, 6 into 5 equal to 30 marks. This way 30 plus 40 plus 30 altogether questions of 100 marks will be asked in the final examination. This way every topic is important. There is not a single topic which can be ignored, because from each topic questions will be asked. And if we give importance to the mark, on basis of mark, mainly 6 marks questions will be asked from vector. From vector topic, there will be question of 2 plus 6 equal to 8 marks. Very important topic. Derivative. From derivative, also 2 plus 6 equal to 8 marks. Conic section, coordinate space, either from conic section or from coordinate in space, 2 plus 6 equal to 8 marks. But these two topics are very important, vector and derivative and its application, because from these two topics it is sure that there will be 2 plus 6 equal to 8 and 2 plus 6 equal to 8. Sometimes from statistics also we can get 2 plus 6 equal to 4 marks. 2 marks here, there is no any fixed pattern, but the pattern is 2 plus 4 or 2 plus 6. In this way, questions will be asked in the final examination. Hope you all have understood the syllabus, the course contents of class 12 of science stream, and the evaluation scheme, how many questions will be asked from which topic in the final examination. This is the course pattern which we'll be discussing in the class 12. So in next video we'll be discussing on particular topic. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe and share. Thank you very much.